Hello, and welcome back to new episodes. The question of today. Do I believe in religion? No, or yes. In more specific sense, if you mean that I believe in one magical deity, what creates the whole galaxy in one clip with our fingers, and that acts or look like humans do? No, they're not. But I believe in a sort of a kind of gods, or but my god is not like humans. My god's more like nature. The essence of my god is in compassion. This in any plant, this in any animal. My god is sensitivity. My god is peace. My god is compassion. My god is not war. It's devil play. War is greedy old man sending your foolish children to poor countries to protect their property and kill young children. That's war. War is also destroying habitats and stealing land, what not belong to them, and taking it a little bit more. There's no nobility in war. There's only nobility in protecting victims from victimizers. So in defending, but not in war. This whole world doesn't belong to humans. It all belongs to other species. It is humans that take active a little bit more, and a little bit more, and a little bit more. But what most atheists do is attacking Christianity, dualism, and Islam. Understand that I try to change it for the good way. You must understand that you don't change a lot of people by only putting things out of religion and say, oh, this is what they do, this is what they do. No, you have to see the whole picture. Not all Muslims being terrorists, not all Muslims being rapists, not all Christians being slave masters, white supremacists like Donald Trump. Yes, we all know that Donald Trump is friends with the KKK. Is it not? I'm serious. If humans truly look to nature, not only what humans say, but actually look into nature, take their time, and look to other plants, how they grow, and how the insects live, and all, to all the cows, the pigs, chickens, the deer, and look in their eyes, I say you will understand what many before you know. That nature is not the enemy, and that we have to try to live in harmony with nature. And on top of that, if you believe in any religion, Jewish, if you've been Jewish, if you've been Muslim, if you've been Christian, in Genesis, God created the earth, the animals, and other species. So, if you're murdering God, if you murder animals, the planets, and other humans, you're murdering God piece by piece. The only logical conclusion is to change the evil parts and put them away out of it. For example, most of Sharia law. A lot of the stuff in that book being terrible. But so, you can also say, this of the law, the law of your state. Do your research a little bit. I know not know any law of any land. But if you have a law in your country, and that law is crazy and insane, put them in the description below. I like to see that. I like to see which kind of crazy laws you know that you have in your state. But that's my point. You don't have to be an absolutist and obey any law or put the whole laws away. What I mean is that you don't have to be an absolutist. I myself am not an absolutist. I know that in any place mean truth and in any place mean lies. And I also know that in, around whole history it have shows that if you tell a lie long enough, people will believe the lie. Something that Joseph Goebbels, the Nazi propaganda minister, read of Hitler many times to show. You can trick people easily. You can trick humans easily, accepting outrageous lies. For example, that Hitler was vegetarian or vegan. It's absolutely crap. Look on my video titled the Hitler was not a vegetarian or vegan, and the Holocaust is based on the animal agriculture industry. To figure that out. And being atheist, you're not by definition a good person. I know a lot of vicious, totally insane persons that claim that to be an atheist. For example, the Imagine Atheist, one of the most biggest phonies on the whole planet, is totally loco. In my opinion, he seems like a crazy, fat, psycho weirdo. It's constant insult others for no good reason. I also say things that people don't like, but I have my reasons for it. I don't be a dickhead because I can be a dickhead, just like the Imagine Atheist. So, being Christian, being Jew, being Muslim, being Buddhist, don't make you a bad person. Just like being an atheist make you also not a good person? By definition. A good person become you when you act moral responsibility, with moral responsibility and without disharmony in your actions. Animals being not food. Just like Jesus have said in the Apostle of the Nazirenes. Become who hell wants to be my disciple. Hold your hands from bloodshed and let no meat enter your mouth. But the Lord has said that man shall live on the fruits and seeds of the earth. A sheep will, like with a wolf, calf will feed with the bear, and the lion will eat straw like the horse, and a little child will eat. And nobody will murder or slay on my holy mountain. Yes, I am. So, live just by the golden rule. Do to others just like you want that they do to you. Since nobody in the whole world wants to be treated like a cow, a pig, a turkey, it is more logical to become vegan. And for the people who claim that gods have give humans dominions over other animals according to their religion, that's the same kind of dominions that their parents have over their children. According to the same criteria, you know. That don't mean that our parents have the right to do anything with their wants to their children. I just say, think a little bit logical and understand that all these books being collected by humans, no matter if you believe that being written by God, all these books being collected from different people out of history, being put together to support one status. For example, the Bible is made up out of different manuscripts from different people in the time of different followers of Jesus from Nazareth, and being put together by Claudius Conquistador in the beginning of the 4th century. This man was totally crazy and extremely lunatic, just like any of the Roman emperors. He put this all together to support one agenda of hatred and disease, from speciesism to heterosexism to sexism to racism and to classism and all the other systems of discrimination. Today, Christians and Muslims have not to be, and Jews and Buddhists don't have to be shocked to find out that the masters of their states have used these books to promote one agenda of violence and disease. But religion is nothing more than an instrument. It can be used for good and for evil. That is what it means, actually. Religion is not bad by extension. But always, the people that have to power to do good with it or bad. And all around whole history, it has shown that people with power always misuse the power. So, one important thing, that's the last one. One of the most important things that people, young people, particular have to learn in this age, is to think for themselves. Understand that compassion have always to conquer industrialized violence and cruelty. But all living beings deserve equal rights. That all animals being created equal, and that humans don't being superior in any way. And that we have to learn to live in harmony with the laws of species diversity and give any innocent living being their rights where they deserve from the day that they have been born. Is it just so hard for humans to be peaceful instead of cruel? God lived not in a book. God lived not in a golden mirror. God don't live in a likeness of Jesus. God don't live in a holy wall. God don't live in one black stone. God lived also not in the likeness of Jesus located in the Holy Sepulchre. God lived not in one piece of paper. I don't believe in ink and paper. I also don't believe in humans. I believe in compassion. I believe in morality. I believe in my own power to make this world at least a little bit more sane. To put and unravel all of the and a lot of all the evil on this world. That's my duty. My duty is not to humans. My duty is not to the society. My duty is to the planet. My duty is to the seas. My duty is to the forest. My duty is for all the animals on this planet to be tortured and abused by humans. My duty is for harmony. And if you don't can handle that, maybe you have to look to your own inner self. That There was one time that I fight against Christianity. There was a time that I fight against most of all religions. And that I can call myself an atheist. Today, I fight that fighting against religion is stupid. Because all religions claim that they give about compassion. Just like all the atheists claim that they give about morality. All humans on the whole planet, all groups of humans claim, but not a show, that they give about compassion. And there have been just as many good Christians, good Muslims, good Jews, good Buddhists. Is there been people that don't believe? By my opinions. People lie in deceased, no matter if they believe or not. People steal, people do anything unjust. If they believe or they don't believe. Either way, it is a choice. You only have to have no inconsistencies in your call it religion, call it philosophy, call it whatever you want. And all just concepts used by a delusional monkey with a god complex. And go just vegan. That's the only way to live in moral, in justice. That's the only way that you can live without inconsistency. As long as humans shed the blood of innocent creatures, they will never find health or peace. As long as humans will murder one another, they will not find justice, health, or this. With absolute surety, if your God is compassionate, friendly, moral, and not insane, and irrational, your God wants that all that you protect and that you respect all innocent life. Pigs, cows, chickens, turkeys, elephants, zebras. They have harmed nobody ever in the whole life. The least you can do is become vegan. And try to eliminate the extreme amount of harm that humans do on this planet on a daily basis. If God allowed that animals in vivisection laboratories be tortured and abused, if God allowed that animals in concentration camps that we so euphemistically refer as slaughterhouses being cut, hang upside down, screaming for their life, if God say that is good, if God say that it been good to rape animals by vaginal allergy, it's a cruelty, and rip their skin off. If God say that it been good to rape mother cows and call that artificial insemination, and then after birth steal their children away, just like the Nazis have done in World War II with the Jews. If God allowed and love that humans hunt animals down for their horns, rhino horns, elephants. If God prays it that somebody cuts the throat of a live animal and puts them in fire for burn offerings. If God allowed it, what can do the devil then? What can the devil then do? If God allowed that. In other words, if you say that you God allowed the torment and abuse of animals, then the devil you condemned is not better than the God you glorified. In other words, you worship a devil. It is time to truly worship God and His creations by worshiping His creations, the animals, the planets, and each other. Instead that you only worship the root of all evil, money, greed, gluttony, your stupid pride. You stupid fanatics and all of the other unforgivable and deadly sins. For all the Christians, for all the Muslims, for all the other religion people. You all been deadly sins. If you eat animal products and you support child slave labor by buying the products, you be responsible. Stop blaming others for your bad actions and stand self yourself and stand against it. Stand for something. Stand for one moral standpoint. And don't be a hypocrite. Don't listen to what others have to say if it's being immoral. Try to find a way out of it. Become an activist, actually. It's best to live your life for one course, instead to live your life for yourself. Stand for something. But also always understand why you fight for. Don't follow somebody blindly. Because how following somebody else blindly become an easy target for one charlatan. Go vegan and oppose discrimination for good. Instead of you play hypocritical politics, correctness games that actually do nothing in the long run. The only ones around whole history that been that have made actually substantial change for the victims. Being the activist. Cesar Chavez. Muhammad Gandhi. John Africa. Malcolm X. Jesus Christ, all were radical lawbreakers that been put many times to prison. Well, there are also to say, if you look to the eyes of the victims, anything is justifiable to get your freedom. I've been also sometimes so surprised that victimizers and people that do evil things become so upset and so offensive when somebody say that their hope that they become evil things to them what they committed to themselves become just logical. Step out of your cognitive dissonance. Or your delusional mindset that humans being superior to and therefore have the right to torment and abuse and commodify other living beings. Because humans believe that they're being better than other animal species. Humans believe that they're being more intelligent, more holy, more sacred than other animals. Because they have languages. Because they walk on 2 feet. Because they claim they have so big brain. To use this arbitrary criteria. Have the body of a human. Maybe they do very more intelligent things than we do. We don't can claim it, or we can also don't deny it. We don't can say this be true 100%, but we also don't can deny it. So just become logical. You don't can be for discrimination based on arbitrary criteria. Arbitrary criteria being things like skin color, being things like hairiness, being things like being male, or being white, or being pale skin, or being a fan of Lord of the Rings, or being fan of Aragorn, or being fan of I say just wearing socks or don't wearing socks. In all stupid reasons to harm and discriminate and enslave other groups. Blacks historically the positions of racism and sexism being by challenging the intelligence and superiority of certain groups of humans, women and black people. And the increasing of the superiority and the intelligence of the victimizer. All the times arbitrary criteria. You have always to put yourself in the position of the victims if you choose right from wrong. If you do it by the victimizers, it becomes pretty easy to mock and excuse cruelty, inequality, slavery, rape, and even murder. But when you mean the victim, things look a lot different from that angle. There is no excuse for what they do to you. Go just vegan. beans, lentils, legumes, fruits like bananas, like apples, like dragon fruits, like kankies, like blueberries, like except like pears, strawberries. You can also eat potatoes, noodles, a lot of stuff that you actually can eat. You also first step out of your mindset. Put the right mindset on. Some do it overnight, some do it directly. I hope that you choose the most moral position and put all the animal products away and go on this moment vegan and live in harmony with your conscious again. Go vegan. That's the excuse for causing the least amount of harm possible on this planet. If you call any human treachery, I can say to you that come never even close to where all the animals, all the 150 billion animals that humans exploitate, murder, and commodified any year. Come not even close to it, Lord, the humans. Or even the most brutal tree that humans go to. Animals be the most biggest victim, and the biggest victims of this whole planet. Pigs, chickens, turkeys, they've been the most biggest victims ever. What have they done? Nothing. Only because humans think they have the right. Just like the Nazis in World War I. Just they think that they have the right to do it with Jews. Just like the black people. Just like the white privileged slave owners think that being just their right to commodified blacks and force them to work for them, and if they don't work, kick them with the whip, just like the pharaohs believe that they have to do that, have the right to do that with one of some of their poor people in their country and force them to work with whips to the ground. See the truth and make the connection. Cut that blinders up. That make you absolutely incapable of using logic and compassion. All animals can choose to be kind or not. Either way, it is a choice. And therefore, in a more saner world, our justice system will not fall. And don't want to insult and harass because it don't give about money. It so have to give about justice, morality, equality, not